To the butthead, if I ever catch you leaving your dog's blank in my yard again, you will be sorry. I have a camera from the owner. I feel like I've said this before, I do honestly have this kind of issue around my neighborhood, and I've almost flung doggy doo-doo bags up into my frame of my car while I'm driving, so if I ever do find the dude, you can almost guarantee that he's gonna wind up on the channel in this specific playlist. Hello everybody, and welcome back to another video for the day. We're going back to r/iamatotalpos, cause honestly, let's admit this world sucks. If you guys would like to be absolutely amazing, show your support, and see more videos like this one in the near future, be sure to hit that like button, leave a comment down below to start up the wholesome internet discussions, and if you have not already, subscribe and turn on notifications. Also, check out another video or two, that'd be darn dandy. Kansas police officer's German Shepherd puppy beheaded in what authorities are calling a targeted attack. The level of cowardice that would lead someone to off a little puppy named Ranger is astonishing. Out of all the acts of violence, I honestly feel like hurting puppies or baby animals in any way, shape, or form is gotta be one of the lowest of the lows, definitely. Like, what was this dude trying to do? Send a message to the cop? 36 kilograms of explosives used for a gender reveal party in the US. The blast shakes homes 32 kilometers away. Parents-to-be use around 36 kilograms of explosives for a gender reveal party in the US Kingston, leading to a blast that shook houses over 32 kilometers away. Some nearby residents even reported property damage, and some thought it was an earthquake. No injuries were reported, police said. The person who bought and detonated the explosives has turned himself into police. You know, out of all of the years that humans have been alive and all the human history and all of the natural disasters that could have happened, I honestly am fairly certain that Yellowstone is going to be set off because somebody finds out it's a boy. This lady stole my 5-year-old nephew's dog and sold her, so please, if you know someone or have gotten a dog of blank, please tell me or my family. Also, if you are considering letting her look after your dogs, this is the third family she has done this to, so no one give her your animals. Missing Nala so much. You really got some audacity coming in here acting like these dogs. Oh no, I can't take care of them, so I need to sell them. Yeah, they weren't yours in the first place. I was going to donate $7,600 to a fund, but I found out her parents are lesbian. I've chosen to donate to St. Jude due to that fact. Sorry, I'll still pray for her though, but maybe it's God's way of getting your attention that she needs a mommy and a daddy, not two mommies. Same blank parents of a little girl battling stage 4 cancer get hateful message from a would-be donor. You know, if you don't do a good thing because of this for some reason, it doesn't exactly paint you in the best light. Like, seriously, in all honesty, what does the parents being lesbian have to do with anything in regarding to the stage 4 cancer? Delaware daycare workers are accused of running a toddler fight club. What in the Florida man heck is this?
Hey, you know what? This might just be me, but a lot of people find it a little bit of a douchey move when you have a trailer and you can't bother to frickin' put it all the way in.
Plus, this is all just kind of common courtesy. If you have a trailer, you park in the back of the lot where there's nobody around. That way, even if you have to take up 4 parking spots, nobody's really gonna get that much upset at you. If you do this stuff where you park right at the front and you can't bother to actually park courteously, then you'd rather not have the trailer. Everybody's gonna be having a lot better of a day if this person just didn't do that. Like, seriously, this is a Home Depot lot. There are spots, you just don't want to walk. Which is kind of funny, though, you think of it, because the person put in the extra effort to connect the trailer to the vehicle, but didn't want to park it courteously, you know, because it's a Home Depot lot. You know for a fact, in the back, there are some spots available. Like, seriously, dingus, just do a drive-thru, you'll fit.
I finessed a champion fanny pack, and it's filled with inhalers, EpiPens, and a bunch of medical blank. I feel bad now. Poor kid is probably unable to run from the cops because I got his inhaler.
Imagine thinking you're cool, thinking that you can just change up words and change the whole thing. Just because you use the word finessed instead of robbed or stolen doesn't make you any better of a person. Plus, isn't it like you can be held responsible if something were to happen to the person if you stole their bag and then it
had the medical supplies they needed in that instance. Like if you took somebody's bag and it had heart medication, and then when you robbed them, they had a heart attack, that kind of thing. This woman is responsible for the leaking to the internet of the real name and real address of the 10-year-old Brazilian girl that made a legal deletion after becoming pregnant for being blanked by her uncle from the age of 6 until the age of 10. Because of this trash of a human being that was released from jail and was able to access Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, etc., the girl had to hide inside the trunk of a car to enter the hospital to perform said deletion. She broke Brazilians' laws that protect children. Lots of people went to said hospital to protest it, calling the kid a murderer, and so the doctor. The kid was freaking 10. But of course, you're gonna have these Bible thumpers that come up and say, oh, it's God's plan, let it happen. No. And the worst part is that some of those same Bible thumpers or the people that went to protest it probably think that this person here is a hero. Don't feel bad for them. They let their 10-month-old daughter die because they refused to take her to a doctor. These Christians just realized they face life in prison for killing their baby. Yeah, ain't that weird how that works? You end somebody else's life, there's a pretty good chance that you aren't gonna be able to live yours out. I mean, technically you are, but prison, it doesn't seem like much of a life to live anyway. You are not commanded by God to be a footballer, or anything for that matter. Get a husband and start a family. Football might damage your fallopian tubes and you may be barren. Wise up. Money loving is evil. Money is a tool. Without it, you can still be happy. Find a God and a husband. Oh yes, and then be broke and with a kid. Because that's what you're saying, right? Well, I can guarantee you if I chose between having money and no kids versus having kids and no money, there's a pretty good indication of which one of those I would like to choose.
So, my boyfriend and I have blank once a month. It's not like I don't like blank, but I don't want our relationship to be centered around blank every day, every time we meet. I love him very much, so I need to set standards for him to see value in me, but deep down, I crave blank every day. Recently, I've been seeing this guy. I don't love him. I don't see my future with him, so I feel comfortable having blank with him every day. I don't mind if he sees me as a blank, but I'm just using him to satisfy my urge. Hey, you know who would be able to help about that? The person you're already in a relationship to. Why do you even think that's okay?
They all deserved it. Time for this part of the world to have a cleanse.
You have a really wicked soul, as if you know these victims personally. Scary that someone feels okay even releasing that kind of energy into the world. What did they do? For anybody wondering about any sort of context for this is the comment section for a video covering recent tornado events in Kentucky.
I'm speaking the truth. You didn't have to reply to me, though. The next round of this won't happen again until this part of the world needs another cleanse.
You know, I gotta say, I think the one thing I find the most funny when people try to talk like this whole it is God's plan thing to justify the bad things happening, you gotta wonder, are they gonna do that whole it's all God's plan thing when that bad thing is happening in their own backyard? A guilty verdict has been reached in this person's murder, who was offed in 2019 while trying to retrieve his stolen laptop from an Oakland Starbucks. He helped his family to commit offing and then told them he would do the same. Instead, he surrendered to the police. A California man convinced his family to commit offing after telling them he would meet them in the afterlife. Instead, he surrendered to the police on Earth. Recently, this Superior Court judge sentenced Blank to 3 life sentences without the possibility of parole, and pled guilty to 3 counts of first-degree murder of his children and 1 count of deliberately aiding his wife to die by offing. What the actual Blank do you do when someone you have liked for 8 years suddenly likes you back?
update, it turns out it was some sicko prank designed to blank ruin me. See, she planned with some of my not anymore friends.
Yeah, don't you know, just playing with people's emotions is just your friends doing you wrong, okay? You know, it's only emotionally messing you up.
But with that, that is going to have to be it with the video. If you guys would love to be absolutely amazing, show your support, and to see more videos like this one in the near future, be sure to hit that like button, leave a comment down below to start up the wholesome internet discussions, and if you have not already, subscribe and turn on notifications. I'll be sure to see you guys in the next one. Thank you so much for watching, and bye-bye.